The weirdest thing I've ever seen OnePlus advertise is that here on their new flagship, they have a vapor chamber that can be torn apart by your bare hands. You know, the thing that keeps your processor cool is now as strong as a post-it note, and it'll be curious to find out why this is a good thing. I would bet that out of the 8 billion people on this planet, not a single person has ever asked for a cooling system they could split like a Pop-Tart, but since OnePlus is offering, I would like to be the first to see if the claim is valid. I purchased this Sandstorm variant of the OnePlus 15 for my durability test, but it turns out OnePlus has changed far more than just the vapor chamber, and it is way more durable than I expected. The metal frame feels absolutely exquisite. OnePlus has added a new surface finish to the metal called micro arc oxidation, and they say this coating is 3.4 times tougher than aluminum and 1.3 times tougher than titanium. The metal feels like soft touch glass, man, I'm a fan. Even though I always have a case on my phone. OnePlus is using Gorilla Glass Victus 2 on the front screen. We can work our way up through the Mohs scale of hardness. Seeing scratches at a level 3 would mean plastic, and that'll be relevant here in a second. Levels 8 or 9 would be sapphire, but we haven't seen that in a long while. This OnePlus 15 has very visible scratches at a level 6, with deeper grooves at a level 7. Kinda nifty how the background changes every time I unlock the phone. The front-facing camera is 32 megapixels and is protected with the same slab of Gorilla Glass Victus 2. The earpiece slit is razor thin and sits right between the screen and the frame. Speaking of which, this new micro arc oxidation is actually pretty awesome. Yeah, the tip of my razor blade can still do damage, but the MAO coating is far thicker and far more resilient than anodizing. It's actually resisting my razor blade, which means that in real life, the micro arc coating will handle normal scrapes and bumps far better than anodizing. Micro arc oxidation feels like the strongest coating ever applied to a smartphone, and I hope we see more of it in the future. Being partially impervious to razor blades is about to put me out of a job. The bottom of the OnePlus 15 has our 80-watt USB-C charging port, lower stereo loudspeaker, as well as a dual-sided SIM card tray that has a red rubber ring for the IP69 water-resistant rating. And yes, it is IP69 instead of IP68, like everyone else. This OnePlus 15 is far more water resistant than any iPhone or Samsung on the market. Huge thumbs up for that. OnePlus is so far ahead in the waterproofing game that their only competition is with themselves on last year's OnePlus 13, which is also an impressive IP69. Nice. One thing that surprised me though was that my razor blade was leaving marks on the back panel of the Sandstorm colored OnePlus 15. So it looks like my job isn't going anywhere after all. After seeing MKBHD's video about the invincible glass on his phone, I am shook that my own phone is more shredded than the cheese on Taco Tuesday. Turns out OnePlus has put a fiber-reinforced plastic panel on the Sandstorm variant, while the Infinite Black and Ultraviolet colored versions have glass. Also fun fact, the USA just released a new quarter, and for the first time ever it shows a person using a wheelchair on the face. Her name is Stacy Park Milburn. You might start seeing these in circulation. Quarters can also scratch the plastic. There's nothing wrong with plastic, of course, but plastic will take damage if it comes in contact with something abrasive. And personally, I prefer plastic. Even though it might scratch, I feel like it's more durable overall since it won't ever shatter. Cracked glass would bother me way more than a scratch on plastic. Even my new cool digital scribing tool leaves marks. And thankfully, the camera lens covers are not plastic. The top 50 megapixel main camera is protected by the same piece of glass as the lower 50 megapixel telephoto, and the 50 megapixel wide angle camera is over on the upper right side of the camera plateau in a glass circle all by itself. The dual tone tri-LED flash is also protected with glass. The camera bump has more of that thick micro arc oxidation coated metal. It's just as shocked as we are to learn that the back panel is plastic. Longevity is important. I like to keep all of my devices for a really long time. For example, this is my 7-year-old titanium Ridge wallet that I've carried in my pocket every day. Ridge has graciously offered to sponsor this video as I finally bring myself to upgrade. I could have obviously used Ridge's lifetime warranty to replace the worn-out straps, since replacement parts and screws are free forever, and I probably still will. But Ridge just dropped their second generation wallet. It's 10% lighter, more modular, and Ridge is having their biggest sale of the year right now on some of their wallets with up to 47% off. I switched to a front pocket Ridge wallet more than half a decade ago because my back was hurting and I've never looked back. I also use the Ridge 45-watt dual USB-C port power adapter when I travel. It's got two ports and comes with two USB-C cables, 3-foot and 6-foot. It's way easier to doom scroll with a longer cable, trust me. I'm starting to realize that my favorite color at the moment is probably orange. But Ridge has sold over 5 million wallets, and there's a design out there for everyone. Some even include MagSafe magnets to connect with your iPhone. Get up to 47% off with a link in the description, or head to ridge.com/jerryrig. You don't gotta take my word for it though. Every wallet has a 99-day risk-free trial and a lifetime warranty, and it's hard for 100,000 five-star reviews to be wrong. ridge.com/jerryrig. Ridge is making gift-giving pretty easy this year. The 6.8-inch screen on the OnePlus 15 is 165Hz, which means it's great for gaming and can dim as low as half a nit for nighttime scrolling. And for some reason, it is unaffected by the heat from my lighter. No complaints on my end. I am curious though if the plastic back is going to affect the structural integrity at all. Bending the OnePlus 15 from the back leaves us with no flex. However, flipping it around to the front, with my thumbs on the screen, it does start to flex ever so slightly. And I feel like the camera bump is lifting against the plastic a little bit. But nothing that would insinuate that the IP69 waterproof rating is compromised. I imagine if we stopped right now, the OnePlus 15 would go on to live a long, happy, watertight life. If we stopped right now. Unfortunately for OnePlus, they did make a claim that only I can verify, and I wouldn't want to leave you guys hanging. Is the OnePlus 15's 360-degree cryovelocity cooling system really able to be ripped in half by bare hands? Nobody has ever asked, nor has anybody ever cared, but the claim has been made and now needs to be verified. I got you. Plus, plastic-backed smartphones are way easier to take apart than glass-backed counterparts. I end up with fewer glass slivers in my fingers. The camera plateau is clipped very securely into the motherboard plastics. I imagine the clips are there to hold it in place since there's no rigid glass being rigid. I should probably turn it off at this point. I'll remove the 8 screws at the bottom, 10 screws at the top, all Phillips head. My toolkit is linked down in the description. I'll unclip the triple LED camera flash and NFC pad from the mainboard. This black plastic protects the motherboard as well as has the circular copper coils for the 50-watt wireless charging pad. There is no red battery, and some of you aren't even old enough to remember that reference, but there is a whopping dual-cell 7,300mAh battery, which is just a smidgen behind the 7,500mAh battery in the Red Magic 11 Pro. It's also basically twice the capacity of the battery in the iPhone 17, but who's counting? I am. The pull tabs are strong enough to pull the battery out by themselves. Nice work for that, OnePlus. It also says lithium-ion battery on the cell itself, but OnePlus is calling it a silicon-carbon nanostack battery. Under the battery, we do get our first look at that hand-terrible vapor chamber. It's still pinned under the rest of the components though, so I don't have full access to it yet. The lower loudspeaker comes out next. It has a little sticker covering the trap door, which reveals the OnePlus 15 does have balls inside. And plenty of them. Moving up to the motherboard, I'll unplug two long extension ribbons and two of the wire signal cables. There's another singular black screw in the center of the motherboard that holds the whole thing down. The front-facing 32-megapixel camera apparently has a custom RGBW sensor with a white pixel to help improve the low-light performance, but the rear cameras do not have that extra white pixel inside. The main 50-megapixel camera does have optical image stabilization, along with the 50-megapixel 3.5x telephoto, but the 50-megapixel wide-angle camera does not, which is pretty normal. Finally, we start to see the 360-degree cooling system that OnePlus says is terrible. And by terrible, I'm speaking of its rippability and not its capability. There is some regular thermal paste on the backside of the motherboard. This conductively connects the Snapdragon 8 Elite Gen 5 to the vapor chamber. Underneath that thermal paste and the copper shielding is some blue thermal compound. The blue coloring comes from the extract of the milk in Star Wars. But alas, we still cannot get to the terrible vapor chamber itself. The lower charging port board with its 80-watt USB-C port comes out next. This has a red rubber ring around the tip to maintain the IP66, IP68, IP69, and IP69K water resistance ratings. This guy's basically a submarine. We also see the rectangular haptic vibration motor below the charging port board. However, it's at this point that we come to a crossroad. The vapor chamber is stuck under the screen, and if we remove the screen, the phone dies. Since this is a serious discussion, I'll put it up to a team vote. Let me know down in the comments if we should continue the autopsy, even if it means certain doom for the phone. I'll give you a second to decide, and thank you for your vote. Let's get rid of the screen. With the screen lifted up, the vapor chamber and its graphite coating is now visible, and it is indeed extremely large. I assume that OnePlus wants the vapor chamber to be thin enough to be tearable, so it can transfer heat quicker to the vapor inside. Since the phase change of the vapor in the vapor chamber is what's doing the heavy lifting when it comes to cooling the phone, so the quicker the heat gets there, the better. And would you look at that? The vapor chamber of the OnePlus 15 is in fact terrible. I'm glad we checked. Totally worth it. Just like the sale at ridge.com/jerryrig, up to 47% off. Nice work, OnePlus, and thanks a ton for watching. I'll see you around.